Let's dive into our next segment where we take a look at news, notes, and nuggets related to this hobby that we love, that we've cultivated, aggregated from around the web into what we call hobby happenings. Well, and it was with this tweet that ProSet is officially back after 30 years as an official trading card brand of Leaf trading cards. A press release issued this week stated, "The hobby's excitement and appreciation for the hobby's greatest brands is easily at an all-time high. The opportunity to resurrect one of the hobby's early innovators is one Leaf just could not pass up," quote. Leaf's CEO, Brian Gray, added, "ProSet was my first job in the industry, and the chance to lead its rebirth in the hobby 30 years after my time there was an irresistible opportunity. Our intention with this brand is to provide a range of offerings which will appeal to collectors at all levels, from the casual fan to the hardcore collector. Congrats on this endeavor, Brian."
A headline like this is sure to garner attention from both inside and outside the hobby. Some of you may or may not be familiar with Joel Platt, a lifelong collector who started the Sports Immortals Museum in Boca Raton, Florida back in 1995. Over the last seven decades, Platt has acquired one of the world's great sports memorabilia collections. In fact, the 82-year-old's high-security vaults in Florida contain more than a million items, ranging from Jackie Robinson's bat to Wilt Chamberlain's high school uniform to the recently deceased Hank Aaron's game-used hat. So, back to the New York Post headline, and just how did Platt turn a $100 million collection into a stock market? Well, through collectible app, of course. One of the first IPOs from the Sports Immortals collection was for Muhammad Ali's Rumble in the Jungle championship belt, one of two known to be in circulation. Collectible app sold 12,800 shares at $10 a pop, generating $128,000. Now, Collectible valued the belt at $428,000, and Platt kept 30,000 remaining shares. According to Ezra Levine, how did I butcher that after we've interviewed the gentleman? CEO of Collectible, "The IPO sold out, but shares have begun trading at prices based on investor demand via a secondary market, which is on their site, similar to that of Wall Street. It's one way for investors to realize profits. So an item can begin trading on the new Collectible trading site," Levine said, 90 days after its IPO sells out. Be sure to check out the full article at the New York Post website to see several of the other high-valued memorabilia items available from that Sports Immortal collection on Collectible app.
It's incredible. I'm just in awe of the industry right now. Well, CBS News Nancy Chen showcased a story on the hobby this weekend. It was pretty cool. Check it out.
The sports trading card business is surging as the pandemic draws people back to a favorite childhood hobby. Nancy Chen shows us why collectors are paying big bucks.
Adam Thomas's sports card store in Oklahoma has been busier than ever.
I've been in this, industry over 30 years and had the store over 22 years, and I've never seen more kids come in the store than this year.
S&S Sports Cards was closed to the public for 3 months at the height of the pandemic, but the store still managed to double its profits last year.
People have had more time on their hands. People are wanting to relive stuff that made them feel good when they were a kid.
The demand currently far outweighs supply.
Mark Warsop is CEO of Panini America, the largest trading card manufacturer in the world.
If you haven't collected trading cards in 20 years, come and take another look. You can buy trading cards with precious gems inside, trading cards made of precious metals.
There's also an element of luck in finding out what's inside a pack. These so-called pulls are often streamed on social media, attracting younger collectors.
Even a basic pack bought for a few dollars may contain a limited stock card worth thousands, and the value only goes up from there. In January, a Mickey Mantle baseball card sold for a record $5.2 million. But the NFL and NBA are fueling the growth in sports trading cards. A signed Patrick Mahomes card auctioned for $861,000 last month.
Don't treat everything as an investment or as a get-rich-quick scheme. Collect what you like, whether that's a player or a team or a type of card, and enjoy the hobby.
And always remember the simple joy in the luck of the draw. Nancy Chen, CBS News, New York.
Sports Collectors Daily reports that the sale of PSA's parent company, Collectors Universe, is now official, and Collectors Universe is now a private company. The new investor group includes not only new chairman of the board and much talked about hobbyist Nat Turner, but also Major League Baseball team owner Ken Kendrick and an all-star studded roster of athletes, including Brooklyn Nets forward Kevin Durant, Arizona Cardinals wide receiver Larry Fitzgerald, Houston Texans quarterback Deshaun Watson, and former world number one tennis player Andy Roddick, among others. Nat Turner has been named executive chairman of the board. Joe Orlando retains his role and title of president and CEO. And now we have a look at each of the individual investment firms involved in the transaction, headed by D1 Capital Partners, Cohen Private Ventures, the Chernin Group, and 35 Ventures.
The hobby is big money, man. Well, with all of this capital investment in PSA, it should come as no surprise that the company continues to aggressively hire for new positions, the latest being for a social media marketing specialist. So if you've ever wanted to work in the hobby, particularly in marketing, this is probably an excellent entry-level opportunity. Visit psacard.com/careers for more details.
If, like me, you weren't aware this 1961 Topps Dice Game Mickey Mantle card existed, you are far from alone. It is one of the rarest of all Topps test issues. This example is the only entry in the PSA card set registry, and only 17 cards from the whole issue appear in the census. This example is currently up for sale at Heritage Auctions. You know we'll provide you with an update when it's getting closer to that gavel hitting.
Yeah, one of a kind. Seems like it's overused, but it's not sometimes, like in this case.
Yeah.
In honor of Topps' 70th anniversary, Major League Baseball wants to hear about your favorite baseball card. Yep, that's right. To celebrate the 70th anniversary of Topps' first set of baseball cards, MLB.com will revisit the most memorable cards to ever hit shelves. To identify the creme de la creme of cards, MLB is asking collectors themselves to share their favorites. So visit the URL on the screen and submit yours today.
You may know Brittany Palmer as an actress, a model, a popular UFC octagon girl, but now did you know she's also an artist and is part of the new Topps Project 70? Her first card released this week, and she's hosting a special giveaway eligible to all who make a purchase. Watch this video for more details.
Hey, what's up? Brittany Palmer here. So my first card just dropped, and I did a 1980s style A-Rod. Super excited about it. I hope you love it. But to go with this card, we are doing a giveaway. One lucky winner is going to win a hand-embellished signed print of this A-Rod portrait that obviously was not on the card, but this is just a nice little bonus. This can only happen at tops.com, so good luck. Mwah.
Well, another week, another auction. Sports Collectors Daily reports that at least four cards are scheduled to become part of the seven-figure club and are confirmed to sell for over $1 million in the latest Golden Auctions event, including this beautiful specimen of Kobe Bryant's 96-97 Topps Chrome Refractor rookie card in a BGS Black Label Pristine 10, one of just two in the world with such a grade. Other cards scheduled for $1 million plus sales are a 1952 Topps Mickey Mantle in a PSA 8. And then there's this 2004-05 Upper Deck Ultimate Signatures LeBron James Logo Man 1-of-1 Patch Auto. And finally, this 03-04 Upper Deck Exquisite RPA numbered to 99 of LeBron as well, graded in a BGS 8.5. Hmm. You know, Ivan, I really, 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 really wished I owned just $1 million card. Right?
We'll talk about that after the break. Some exciting news from hockey. If you, like me, are a fan of Upper Deck MVP and Artifacts because of the rookie redemptions that they offer, well, the full rookie redemption checklists have been added to the GoGTS.net website blog, and you can check them out now. GoGTS.net for more details.
Well, I don't know about you, but last year when Topps announced its partnership with Athletes Unlimited, I'll be the first to admit right now that I took it for granted, really paying it no mind at all. The first release was an on-demand exclusive for their professional softball league. And I thought that was a one and done, or it'd be a repeating year-to-year product. But come to find out, Athletes Unlimited organizes multiple women's professional sports teams, including lacrosse and volleyball, which Topps just announced as their latest Athletes Unlimited trading card offering. The sets cost $14.99 and consist of 50 cards with parallels and autographs randomly inserted. The order window is open until April 2nd. You can visit tops.com to make a purchase or for more details. And this also ties into our Women in the Hobby story we'll talk about later in the program. And that is a look at this week's Hobby Happenings.